Now let's recap whatever we have studied, that is mean, median and mode, where it is used and why it is used. So the mean is most frequently used measure of central tendency because it takes into account all the observations and lies between the extreme, that is largest, and the smallest observation. So it is the middle term of the entire data. It also enables us to compare two or more distributions. So what can be two or more distributions? Say for example, for comparing the average marks obtained by students of different schools for a certain examination. For example, marks obtained by students of different schools for a certain examination. So there is one examination, but there are different distribution, means different marks obtained by the different school, by the students of different school. So this is a situation where there are more distributions. So then we can conclude which school. So by comparing the mean of the different observations or different marks obtained, we can conclude which school has better performance. Now here the point to be noted is that in examination, the maximum marks has a limit and lower marks has a limit. So there is not very high variation. But when the extreme values are in the data that affect the mean, then mean does not reflect the middle value. Say for example, classes, when frequencies have more or less equal values, that is, variation of frequency is not very much, variation of frequency is small, then data is good. But say if one of the class have frequency of 2, have frequency of 2, and there are other 5 classes, and other 5 classes have bigger frequencies, say 18, 20, 25, 35, or even say 100, something like that, then you can see a first one having frequency 2, then there is a too much of the difference in the variation of frequency. Then mean will not reflect the behavior, will not show the behavior of the data. Then mean will not show the behavior of the data. Then median mean is not the best representation of the data. So then we have to find the median. Then mean is not the best representation of the data. So in problem where individual observations are not important and we wish to find a typical observation, the median is more appropriate. For example, finding the typical productivity rate of the workers. Say for example, finding the productivity rate of workers in a country or wages or salaries of employees in in whole country. So this is a huge data. It's a very very big data, lot of variations are there. So these are situations where extreme values will be there. So in these situations, extreme values will be present. You may find some of the employees are getting say salary of 10,000 and some is getting say up to 10 lakh also. So then there is a lot of extreme values are present in this data. So rather than me, taking median is the best representation of the data. So best representation of data, that is to show the central tendency. Central means middle value. So between this value, people are less than this salary, and this value, 50% of the people are above this salary. So then median is the best representation of the data. And also in situation which requires establishing the most frequent values or most popular items, the mode is the best choice. Say for example, finding the most popular TV program watched by all people or most consumer, most used consumer good. Or the maximum color used for the vehicle, maximum color of the vehicle purchased by people. So in this kind of a if we have to establish the most frequent value, so like this one, so mode is the best choice. And also there is a remark that there is a relationship, 3 times multiplied by median is equal to mode plus 2 multiplied by mean. So this is our relationship between the 3 central tendency. So 3 central tendency means 3 values, that is median, mode and mean, median and mode. So the median of group data with unequal class size can also be calculated. However, we will not discuss this, but we can use this formula. The above formula can be used when 2 of the values are given. So you can put the values and take, you know how to move from left to right. And you can do add, subtract, change the sign, and then you can find the value. So this is very easy. If we say this is a very simple equation, we can solve it to find the third value.